Hello guys, today I have some news for you. Some of you maybe saw already or heard it. We decided to change our name. The old name Wohnang Deutschland will now officially change to the new name, which is simply Schön. Or as a full name, Schön Kung Fu Academy, Wohnang Principal. Since quite a while I'm thinking about changing the name, because Wohnang Deutschland was never really a name I could identify with and that is fitting to the school as it is now. This name still comes from a time when Ismet represented the Wohnang lineage here in Germany, and so the name was very fitting, Wohnang Deutschland. But now, since very long time, we are not doing this actually anymore. So the name is not really representing what we are standing for. Yeah? We do with all our heart mostly arts that are coming from the Wohnang Schönbuchai lineage. But we are not representing the lineage. But we go with these arts our own way, in a more free and less bound way to the fixed tradition as they are taught in Wohnang. For a long time I was thinking, okay, what would be a fitting name? And for a long time I could not really find a good one. Yeah? I knew always it has something to do with Schön. Yeah? Schön will be part of the name, and had all kind of nice ideas, but whenever I told these ideas to other people, they told me, oh, it sounds very horrible. And so I was thinking for around 4 years about the name, until I realized actually that we have already the name. We always had already this name that I gave the school now. Because when I took the school, I decided for this logo here. Yeah, the Schön symbol in the stamp. Because I knew this is the symbol the Kung Fu way I want to give on stands for. Yeah, and this symbol is representing the best, the way of Kung Fu as I understand Kung Fu, and I want to practice Kung Fu for myself and therefore also give it on that way. So at a certain point it was very clear for me, okay, actually the school name has to be just Schön. So what does Schön mean? Where does it come from? And why do I think it represents very good the school here? Schön means, in a very simple way translated, hidden or mysterious. And it's also the same Schön as in our Schönbupai lineage, the lineage our Kung Fu comes from. It is the same Schön as from the hidden warrior, Schönbu or Jenbu Dali, the immortal our spiritual teachings coming from. Yeah, and it also was always fitting for me, because I felt like the school we are practicing at is very hidden in the middle of Berlin city. Yeah, in this huge city, there is this place that barely people know. Yeah, and when you come here, suddenly you're not in Berlin anymore. You're in this bubble, in this space, in this protected space where people just focus the whole day for practice. And if you live here around this area, people barely know about the school, yeah, because it's so like in the backyard and protected and away from the fast life of Berlin. So on this side it's a very hidden place, but also in the sense of that our students, when they go out to the street, you look at them, you don't really think, aha, okay, these are people that practice 8 or 10 hours a day Kung Fu. Yeah? They look like everyone else and they act also like everyone else. We're not trying to be something else, wearing specific clothes or talking in a specific way. And also there I feel like these teachings, this Kung Fu, we practice it in a very hidden way. We try to be still part of the society in a way. We try not to be too abnormal, but at the same time we do something quite abnormal for some people's eyes. And also when students sometimes come new to the school, they wonder, okay, now I'm here in the school, I practice Kung Fu, but where are actually the spiritual teachings? Yeah, something is missing here. This could be the first impression of some people, or is the first impression of some people that come here, because we are not having regular lectures about our philosophy, and we communicate everything super clear. Yeah, also on purpose, we don't communicate everything very clear. Yeah, it has its reason. Because many things are also taught in our school through the movement, through the way we teach, the way we act with the students, yeah? The way we try to make the students create awareness, not just in their movements, but also in their lives, yeah? To fill their body and their minds and souls with a specific kind of philosophy and awareness. And this is happening also in a very hidden way. Yeah? Sometimes, of course, we also talk about it and we open it and we try to explain it. Like in this video, I explain a bit something. But the real teachings in the end still happen in the real life. Yeah? No word can replace this. And this is also why I felt always very connected to this Xuan. This was the basic explanation about Xuan and the change of the name. If you are more interested to hear about Xuan and my opinion, my view, my current view on this term and more reasoning why I choose this sign, you can find in the description of the video another video that will bring you more explanation, my bit more philosophical view on this word Xuan. So as I said before, the logo Xuan was already 4 years ago the logo I chose, the sign I wanted to spread Kung Fu with. So actually there is not really a change of names happening. Yeah, the channels are called now a bit different, yes. But the name was already always, and the logo was already always on our t-shirts, yeah, and on our videos and everywhere. So I also redesigned the logo a bit. You will see it here now. But in the end, it's the same sign. It's the same logo. I just refreshed a bit, renovated a bit as you want, if you want to say like that. Yeah. But from there, nothing changes. In the end, we have a name that we had already for a time. And I hope you also like it as we like it. And I thank you for listening to this video and to the explanation. And I hope we will have a lot of good training soon in the future at our academy all together under the name of Xuan and Wudang Principles.